Hello, everybody, and welcome to this episode of Awesome Nods with yours truly, Slow Wolf. Last time, we played up against Nikki. Guess who won? Come on. Guess. Not that you need to. It was the last video, so if you've been watching the series, the chances are you saw that video as well. In this game, I think we're going to retry Sentry, and we're going to retry Sentry because Sentry got some pretty interesting changes to how he plays and works. Now, we still can't do Teleburst, because I know I suck with it. But we are going to try out his new shield upgrade, which allows him to do some damage over time, so long as he's close to people, you know? It's kind of like the burn. Getting close to Sentry is like going to the gym. Well, the opposite of going to the gym, but it's... You know what? It's not like going to the gym at all. I was going to say it's like going to the gym because, you know, you go there and you stay there for like a couple of like seconds or minutes or hours, I guess, depending on how long you stay at the gym. And then you feel a pretty intense burn, and then you go home really exhausted and... whatever, spend your money on comfort food. But with Sentry, it's a little bit different, because you get there, and then you die, and then you respawn back at home, and you're like, well, shit, and then you have the comfort food anyway, but you don't feel the happy burn, like the one where you got your muscles and everything, where you start getting all ripped and jacked and shit, and you're all like, yo, I'm so big, and then, yeah, instead of that, you've got death and destruction and depression and all that stuff, and that's not so good. Unless if you decide to take that philosophy of the, you know, Book of Five Rings, written by that one dude from China, I cannot remember the name to any longer, where, you know, death is inevitable and the universe is going to inevitably become a heat-wasted, empty space with nothing that can possibly live inside of it and all that stuff. And at the end of the day, despite all these impressive facts that, you know, could crush a person, you have to just kind of realize, wait a minute, none of that's going to actually apply to me in my life, and it's inevitable anyway, so I might as well just continue doing my life the way I see fit, because, you know, value is a thing that you create for yourself, and you do these things so that way you can create your own meaning in life and all that. I don't know what I'm talking about. Look, I took a couple of philosophy classes, and sometimes I like to wax philosophical in order to think like, you know, I'm a smart person or something, but anytime that anyone does that, you can just walk up to them, slap them like this, just like that. To do that slap, by the way, you just take your hand, you cup it, just do that. Anyway, you do that clap, you do that slap in their face, and you're just like, snap the fuck out of it, man. You're not that smart. Shit, I could take a couple of philosophy classes. I mean, yeah, it's a bit expensive, but if you take a couple of philosophy classes, you too could sound smart, only for the low, low cost of 40 grand. Oh, low, low cost of 40 grand Canadian. You know what? Depending on the country you're in, 40 grand Canadian doesn't seem so bad. I mean, for university, for some countries, yeah, it's infinitely more expensive. I know that France has university more or less paid for, and depending on your scores in the UK, it's the same deal, but you know what? It's the same deal in Canada. If you do really, really, really well in school, it's pretty much all on scholarships. You don't have to do very much in terms of actually paying your way through. You just have to work hard at your school, keep your grades up, and that can be really tough because of the way that universities grade. Did you know that universities do the shittiest grade schemes ever? Like, university, you're going on blast. Not only do you get people to think that they're so hoity-toity and smart on themselves that they go around the world thinking, oh, I read Camus, oh, I read Aristotle, obviously I'm smarter than all of these plebs. I mean, like, don't get me wrong, if you went to university, chances are you have a better knowledge base than most, and you have, you know, reasonable critical thinking skills, one hopes. But, you know, universities do that, and then they're like, oh, well, you know, there's, like, a bunch of people that did super well in our class. Like, let's take a psychology 101 class, okay? That has like 200 plus people in one section. There's like four sections or to six sections or something like that. So there's well over a couple of thousand people trying to take this course because it's required in most degrees, and people are just like, fuck, come on. So you've got all these students in there, and it's like, well, like, say, like, because the course is a, you know, piece of fucking cake, this thing is really easy to do. So half the class gets a B or above, okay? Half of it. That's too many people, the university says. You need to have half of the people in the class kind of sit on a C. And then you get like 25% that go above the C and 25% that go below the C. And that's just to maintain the image that the university is fucking good at what they do. So if you manage to get your way paid through university because you're that good at school, that you managed to come out on top of a heap that was pretty much, you know, the same people over and over again, then, like, you know, congrats to you, man. But I couldn't fucking do it. Anyway. On the other team, we've got Scoop, we got Clunk, we got Ray. On our team, we got me, Ray, and Ted. We have better push. Let's get started with that particular piece of information immediately. We have better push than these guys. Not by too much. Clunk does have the capacity to push really, really hard, but Ted just does far more turret damage. So, I'm not too worried about that at all. I'm going to toss this teleport beacon in there, toss this baby out here, maybe do some extra damage that way. Yep, that was fair, easy stuff. Is this guy going over to our side? Yeah, he was trying, but we're gonna teleport over here, cut this guy off. Oh, I ate a nice big hammer here. Oh, that's mine, thank you. Oh, no, okay, that's definitely mine. I got the added HP, thank you. Yeah, I wanted out. I got out, because I said so. Ha! We're going to go ahead and put that there, so that way if I do need to teleport back into to get some HP, I can now do that. That's fine, right? That's totally a happy day. Oh, we got him! We got him! Just kill him! Just kill him! There we go. Baby, what a black hole. Okay, so we're managing to land our ship. We're going to teleport back up here, grab some HP. Nothing too crazy or anything. Bingo, that's fine. Honestly, it's little convenient uses of like that for teleportation that's going to make or break some people's play. We're going to grab that 5 solar there. Was it worth it? Maybe not. I'm not sure. We're also going to take some of that damage there, so that way our black hole is a little bit larger. We're going to pull this guy out, do some extra damage that way, and Franks is low, officially. We are going to go ahead, drop this, and teleport home. We can do this really easily because we're sentries, so teleporting back home. We're going to grab this. The piggy bank. Is that the worthwhile upgrade here? You know what? No, we'll refund it. Let's grab one rank in region and say thanks. Thanks. Let's teleport to the middle and get back into the action. Hello! We just said surprise. We're going to toss this out. Oh, is that everybody dead? That is a double kill. That is so big. Oh, what a black hole. And Google Maps is back for a second round with us. And you know what? This I think that I made up for my performance in the last game. Google Maps, if you watch my shit at all, then, you know, thanks for last game. It worked out well. Despite the fact that we lost to Nikki, I think it worked out okay. But this is our game. This is your standout game here. This is by the standard by which we will judge you from here on out. So, you know, no judgment. No pressure. But, like, you know, there's pressure now, so be careful about that. We're going to drop this here, a little bit on the backside, so that we can sneak out if need be. That's uniquely just so that way we can kind of teleport in, and if we're in a bad spot, kind of like slink right out before they realize what's going on. For instance, right now, we're going to go ahead, pop on in, and then just run. And then suck everybody into the same hole. Oh, that damage on that scoop was so real. I wish I had more damage to drop out. That is so unfortunate. Okay, that's fine. Look, pick up all that solar. There's so much on the ground. And let's just get back in here. These teleports are on point. And I think it's largely because these guys are not paying attention to where I'm putting it, to be honest with you. We're also continuously surprising them, which is a nice change of pace, but... Whoop, whoop, hello! Got one. Okay, we need to be careful. Just run. No, okay, that's fine. I just don't get hit by the bite. Back off. Let him blow himself up. Shit. Look, pick up the solar Google Maps. Yes, okay, good. So, that could have worked out better. But hey, you know what? We're 2-1-3. Lots of assists. We've been with our team. We've been helping out a lot. This is all very, very good for us. In fact, out of the 3 assists that we have, that's been 5 kills on the team. We've been around for more than 50% of our team's kills. This is good. This is very good. All right. Now, we have 400 solar. Let's put it to work. We're going to pick up these 2 upgrades. So what we just did. The first upgrade that we picked up, which was, the watch means we go faster. That's fine. We all know what the faster watch does. The other thing that we picked up was the burn damage on his shield. So now if people get too close, they take burn damage, much like Banner the Triple Scoop does for Scoop. So I'm looking forward to seeing how that upgrade works out for us here, considering that we can kind of just come in from behind. Waiting for it. Like this. It didn't work at all. That's unfortunate. We're going to still deal a little bit of damage that way. Honestly, did I pick up the wrong upgrade? Is that a thing? I need to know. That come into contact with it. Oh, so they have to come into contact with it. Okay, that's a little bit less good than I assumed it could be. But who knows? Maybe it'll work out for us. Maybe it won't. I'm a little confused as to whether that will be the case. Oh god, they're so low. Just be careful. Be safe. Oh god, this is not being safe. This is not being safe. Just float. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. But mostly float like a butterfly, so that way you don't get killed. We made it. Okay, we're gonna just go home and heal because we have enough to be able to do that. And you know what? We'll actually keep our teleport right where it is. That's not a bad juke point, honestly, because now if we get a situation where we can never juke away, we can just juke literally back to complete and total safety. What? Excuse me? Okay, first off, they took no damage, but that's expected to a degree. Okay, look. This is gonna hurt. I'm just gonna teleport. Just to do the teleport thing, head back here, grab these creeps, then go back over here, grab this creep over here. These creeps implies I was gonna grab both of them, but like, you know how it is. I don't know how to English, so... We lost Julio Caesar. Shit. Okay, look, just take it easy. One guy's having some connection problems. That's, you know, to be expected. It happens. Look, just have all that solar just go bye-bye. That's fine. This is an interesting upgrade. I'm not sure how I feel about it, but it's an interesting one for sure. I'm expecting this clunk to do his dive bomb technique. On this map, it is not hard to do. You just hit a bounce pad and then call it a good day, drop in on them, and, you know, have a slight tea party at their expense. But at the same time, this is... You know what? I'm not sure how I feel about this upgrade. It's not a lot of damage, and you do have to be right next to them to do it. Like, right next to them. I mean, what's the one way you get people right next to you? In this game, with a sentry? You get them right next to you by, what a teleport! You get them right next to you by using Black Hole. That was incredibly lucky. I looked at the minimap and I thought, I could get in there and help out. Nope, I got a teleport kill. That was not expected at all. So, you know, good for us. Hit that button, grab the solar, or at least one of them. I will take nothing, apparently. That is okay. I did not need to take anything there. Look, we're just gonna drop this, do some extra damage, get the creep kills here, grab this solar as well. That was a lot of extra solar that we didn't necessarily need to have. Whoa, hello! Okay, just back off for a moment. Shit. I was really hoping that the scoop would drop down. He did not. He hurts. He hurts a lot. Look, just go the other way instead. Wait for him to... Look, if I have to, I will bounce the other way. I don't know if that was the weirdest or best juke on the planet, but that was a lot of fun to do. Let's go home. Oh, man. I love being able to keep my momentum when doing jukes like that, but... Okay, what's the plan? We need better left click. This does not do enough. Yeah, let's start going with the damage. Let's piggy bank into the last rank a bit, too. I mean, piggy bank here is maybe a risky pickup. And I say this just because piggy bank isn't, necessarily very good when I need to be the tankiest person on the team to make anything happen. But, okay. One thing I'm looking forward to doing here is possibly doing some... Oh, what a hit! That was actually incredible. I did not expect to do that. That was the world's best airstrike. I'm not sure if he meant to do that. Surprise! We got a kill. What a time to be alive. I'm actually impressed that we got that kill, to be honest with you. We're gonna grab these things here quickly. It's gonna stop him from getting it. So, you know, thank you, I guess. I'm dead. That was so bad. But we got a reasonable kill by just going in and balling out of control. I think we need to remember how to do that. With the upgrades that we have in particular, being able to ball out of control is super important because that's, like, if we don't, we waste an upgrade. Like, we waste the damage upgrade on our shield. We need to be able to just, like, run in and do our thing. So that's what we'll do. We're gonna run in, do our thing. And if we don't do our thing, then, you know what, poopy breath, I guess. What is poopy breath? It's breath that smells like poo. I don't know if you've ever been to grade school before, but that's what it is. If you've never had the chance of being called poopy breath before, or having had someone near you say poopy breath, it is a singularly odd experience. Look, that was at least a reasonable amount of damage, but this Ted is now in a fucking awful spot. Like, an actually awful spot. He is super dead. And so are we if we don't back out. So, back out. Teleport behind them. Then, whoop, hello. Got a kill. That's fine. Just back on out. Boing! Dip in! There we go. Beautiful stuff. That was some crazy good juking. I feel like that worked out nicely. Surprise! Okay, no one got killed. That's fine. Look, we're gonna just drop this here, head home, spend, and then come back. That's our plan. Mustache just does more damage on our thing. That's fine. Increasing the attack speed here. You know what? Let's go with the counterintelligence cross. I got an idea that might just work. I'm not saying this is a good idea. And we're gonna go for attack speed after this, for sure. But, like, This upgrade can be hella annoying. I think that's the main thing, is that we're going for hella annoying against the team that's this big and tanky and stuff. The more hella annoying we are, the better off we are, so. Ow. You got a kill? That's awesome. Okay, head on home. Just take it easy. What? Unfortunate for that guy, but we managed to get a kill there, which is really odd and singular and fantastic, so I'll take it. We're still looking to get that attack speed up and running, so as soon as we got that, we're going to be far more annoying as far as characters go. Oh, good juking, Clunk. Remember, Clunk can practically fly, so doing jukes like that isn't hard, but it is nice to do. It does simplify your life a little bit when you're trying to run away and then just it works out for you instead. Alright, where are these guys at? Let's just set up a minefield here. Hold on. Oh no, he got out! Oh, I was so hoping that would work. I was concentrating so hard to make that one happen. Oh well, that's fine. Look, just set up some mines. Remember, be annoying. Be strong, but be annoying. It's fine. Look, doing some damage is more important than doing no damage. Just keep on doing your thing. Dodge the bad stuff. Go in for those left clicks whenever you see the opportunity. And then just do some damage to these droids. Does that actually help against the droids? I'm not sure. Oh, the gravity is just weak enough that I can't quite catch him on the edge of it. That's unfortunate. Just means I have to aim better, but like, woof. That's a little sad. Okay, look, let's take a look at the stock of this match. Currently, we're doing fine. Their team, also doing okay, but they're not doing as okay as we are. I think that we're winning this currently, so. Just maybe, no. None of them walked into there, that's fine. Back off. We're doing as much damage as we possibly physically can. Caught him and him in it. That is a very dead scoop. Okay, we got him! Sweet! That was really good. Well played by us, and not so well played by them, unfortunately. They kind of bit us and hurt us way too much, despite the fact that we are under the effects of our shield. We are going to go ahead, try to lay in a teleburst, if at all possible. No, not possible. It never is. That's fine. Okay, got another two hits there. Oh my god! Why are we so lucky and yet so not lucky enough? Still, we keep getting close, and that's fine. We're going to head on home for a second. Grab some upgrades, specifically the attack speed one. And then teleport back into it, helping clear the lane out a little. Now we just have to be as annoying as possible using our counterintelligence cross. That was unfortunate. Back off. Look, just take it easy. Drop some stuff. You're doing a decent amount of AoE damage this way. Drop this and run. Just drop it and run. You don't need to be anywhere near there. That's fine. Just drop it a little bit and run. That was incredibly risky. We probably should not have done that, but we did it anyway. Oh, we got him. We got him in there. Dealt some damage. Cleared out the wave. He's low, but that means that our Ted's going to get greedy, isn't he? Okay, no, back off. Take it easy. Don't go too fast. Gotta make this morning last. Well, it's the afternoon, let's be honest. It's past 3 o'clock, which means that my patch notes analysis video is up. Hope you guys watched that one. If not, then don't worry. I'm gonna completely make an ass of myself regardless, right? So, I mean, that's how this works. if I don't make an ass of myself one way, I do tend to make an ass of myself the other 415 other, you know, ways. Okay, dealt some extra damage that way. It's not a ton of extra damage, though, so, like, back off. They got two very tanky characters that can kind of self-heal. So, what is our thing here? Silence? I mean, I think silence is the thing to get here, right? So, back off. We went in for a teleport. If we have a silence and burst, we should be able to do some reasonable work here. But it is easier said than done, so. We gotta take it real easy here. And drop this teleport here. Start laying these down. Okay, that's my fault. Eating a 229 damage missile. It's real intelligent, but it's not like it's the dumbest damage I've ever been taking. Oh, come on! Why? Oh, are you kidding? Okay, got one kill at least. Got another kill. Okay, play smart around the scoop and you might just make it. Got him. Holy shit, what a time to be alive. Look, just go. And we got a guy who joined. Oh, today's the lucky day after all. We might be able to do stuff. And by might be able to do stuff, I mean like seriously? We actually got somebody that rejoined our game and we're not going to be stuck. You know, one day, that will not be the case. We'll be stuck in the game that we're in. With the people that we're in, we would lose this in the new in patch 3.3 as a result of our Ted leaving like that. But that would not be the case. It's not the case now. So as long as we have the ability to have late joins that can come and help us, let's just continue to use them. Yeah. Bye. If I can run, I will run. Now let's go back this way. Yeah, she's gonna run around, wrap around, that's fine. Look, just go over here. Drop one of these. Force them to come in on you. Okay, that's one dead. That's fine. Oh god, don't know why I walked back into that one. Back off, because you know what's gonna happen with that clunk. She's gonna jump in on you like an ass. Back out. Okay, so, like I said before, silence will help us a great deal, so we are gonna grab that. And then I guess just the teleport beacon damage, right? Like that's pretty cool. Last time I checked, it's not like the most important thing on the planet, but it does mean that with silence we're doing a decent amount. Oh hello! Oh no! We got so close. I think I pushed her out by I pushed him out by accident. I did not realize I had more mass than Scoop. Somehow, I mean it makes sense if you think about it. I'm a gigantic honking metal robot that comes from the Power Rangers universe, and then there's this asshole. Oh god, I don't know what I was trying to do there. I'm dead. There is no ifs, ands, or buts about that one. Look, just relax, take it easy, it's okay. You're doing fine, Wolf! We're doing okay, team. We've got a decent amount of damage and everything, we just need to stop being so ballsy, and honestly, we need to think smarter about how we do our teleburst situations. Because teleburst is nigh on impossible. Like, it is very difficult unless if you find yourself in the right situation, which is, you know, by surprise, from above, with, like, no turrets around, that kind of stuff. Like, there can't be consistent sources of damage hammering in the point. Wow, that's bad. That's incredibly bad. Just back out and just start tossing this shit out. Look, there's not much else you can do here. You could, theoretically, teleport home. It's not in your best interests. Drop a few of these. Hopefully get some HP this way. Yep, we got some. That's something at least. There we go. Okay. We're pushing it out. That's fine. We're defending. It's all good. But we gotta play a little safer than what we've been doing so far. This is still very much a close game. This is still a very, very close game. There's a high chance that we lose this. But there's also a high chance that we win this. Like this could go either way right now. And this is in League 5. I'm not pleased with the fact that this is League 5 and that this is what we're stuck with, but oh my lord, we just died horribly. So did Frax, though. Swiggins might die soon. Christ, why is this Scoop so unkillable? It's not like he's got extra heals or anything, but like I dealt a decent amount of damage there. So what's missing? Circuits of Time? Is Circuits of Time what's missing? Do I need just more HP? I don't know what's going on anymore, man. Like, it looked like we were winning for a good long while. So how do we turn this around? Like, they've got big tanks. They take a lot of damage. Okay, that's fair. We need to start being able to take a bit more damage, maybe. I really wish that we could just deal with our teleport here, so we will. Steal this. Then teleport home. It's not ideal. Like, let me get that straight out of the way. That was bad beacon placement based off the fact that I thought that we were being more aggressive. That was not the case, though. So we're not going to end up doing much there. We're going to toss this one down here instead, because I've got a good feeling that they'll end up at that particular position at some point in the near future. I'll just keep tossing out these mines, making it a little bit more difficult for them to deal with this. Oh, Christ. Look, just back off. I'm dealing 135 per shot. Just let me do my thing. Let me be annoying. The instant that I see any of them get too close to that teleport beacon, though, and if it's like too many of them getting too close to the teleport beacon, I'm gonna do it. Oh my lord, we can't catch up to that one. But maybe... No. Okay. Well, we tried. It just didn't end up doing anything at all. Can't risk it. So we're gonna let that HP slide, unfortunately, which sets up well for these guys. Look. We got this thing down. Good. So now what? Okay, got all three of them into the same black hole. Dealt a ton of extra damage that way. They're getting stuck in a time rift. The thing is so low. Come on. Come on. No. Oh. Dealt a lot of damage that way. Dealt a lot of damage this way as well. Shit. Maybe get this Raylan? Is this Raylan a doable? Yes! The Raylan's got gettable. Okay, perfect. Now go in for this last guy. None of this. None of this. Got him. Wow. We are so lucky. Look, just go for the kill. Like, at this point, we gotta go for the jugular, right? Like, we got all three of them. That was a team wipe. Go for the jugular. Like, let's move. Let's roll. Let's do our thing. Okay, if you need to teleport up here, then do so. It's not like it's gonna be... Whoop. Come on. Come on down. Come on down. We got lots of stuff. Du-du-du-du-du. We can kill all the fluff. Okay. Lots of good teleburst there. Unfortunately, there's two of these guys, and they're quite quick, and we cannot left-click and chase them off that way. So we're going to just back off. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. This is tough. We need more damage. Where? Where are we going to get more damage? What am I missing? These. I'm missing the circuits of time. Duh. Okay, look. Get one rank in it, or do we go for... You know what? Disguise mustache. Let's go for the disguise mustache. Get our second rank in HP. We're now tanky as hell. Let's get back in there. Well, survive it. That's fine. Look, just survive it. Do as much damage as you're capable of doing in that situation. It's not well-timed, mind you, because, you know, no one else was there to help, but... Okay, I'll take that one then. Grab another one of these, put it down. We got reasonable HP right now, so that's good. This is a tense one. I don't know where these players come from. I don't know what they do for a living, but currently they are kicking my ass, and it's paying them well. Just back on out. Whoa, God. Fucking hell, man. They came from an area I did not expect. Like, I was not expecting them to come from there and for me to get so fucking stuck. Like, my fuel ran out halfway through jumping up. Sentry's upward mobility is not as high as it, you know, as it is for, like, somebody like Clunk, so it's easy to body block him, and that's cost us. We've died 5 times. That's more than anybody else on the team. Granted, we're also 7 kills in with 10 assists. Like, we've been doing fine overall. It's only overall. Lots of damage. Lots and lots of damage. Unfortunately, lots of damage on us, too. This is garbage, man. Every time we do damage, it's just not enough. They just don't die. Ah. Like, we just don't have enough damage. The Ted, I think we had enough, but... As it stands right now, we just don't. At all. It's really frustrating. I really wish we had a bit more damage, but... Not the case. Oh, what the heck? What a double kill. All right, let's go. Let's go. Surprise. Oh, got him. We got the teleburst and everything on him. But look at how much HP this asshole has. How are you supposed to kill this? Like, he has so much HP. It is impossible to kill this Clunk. However... We can still do some damage to this turret. And then back out. Okay, that's fine. We did what we could. Now we gotta fight on their turf again, which is scary as fuck, because there's a high chance we could lose some people here. Look, don't try to chase me. I will black hole you. Look, run, run, run! I realize Clunk is low. This does not mean he'll be low for long. I'm dead. Ah, no way. I got murdered so hard, I couldn't even see what happened to me. Okay, That's Rivid. Ah, fucking fuck. We did so well, and it's just not enough. They got way tanky. Like, this guy has all the HP. He must. He doesn't. Just power pills? And he's got that much? He just doesn't die. It's really fucking, like, annoying. We're 26 minutes into this game. Things are looking rough because we just cannot kill them. It's not physically possible. We're teleporting there and immediately teleporting back so that we can just get our teleport back. We also simultaneously and hilariously kind of stole a creep, but, you know, it's not exactly the story of the century or anything. Like, toss that out. It's going to do, like, a tiny bit of damage. What's going to be more important is this thing right here. Drop as many photon torpedoes as possible. Oh, Swiggins. Swiggins is dead. Swiggins is deceased. There's nothing we can do about that. Dealt a ton of damage, but it's not going to be enough all on its own, unfortunately. It's okay. Go ahead, grab these things on the way back. Then come in from behind, maybe? Surprise! We tried. Now it's just time to get the scoop here. He's dead. Attack. Go for it. Like we keep killing them, and we're just not doing enough with it. That'll help our creep wave just get ahead. We didn't get the last hits on it or anything, but it's, like, who cares at this point? We gotta just do our thing and tank this as much as possible. Okay, we're not taking it any more than that, unfortunately, so back off. Yeah, I'm not teleporting to that, bud. Don't even think I am. Unfortunately, this means that we are also without a teleport for the next little bit, because we're stupid. We should not have put it there. Surprise! Bye! Okay, now I have a fully charged black hole, but it's not going to last for very long, so, you know, don't expect it to. If there is a fight breaking out up here, I would like to put this to good... No. Back out. That's fine. Well, head on home. Okay, we managed to get out of there just barely. I guess we're going for circuits of time. I mean, there's other stuff here. Teleport to the beacon increases your attack speed. A bunch of healing. Yeah, we're going to go for the circuits of time here and see if we can't go for the full teleburst. Because if we can get that damage and get, like, some more reliable kills, that will be super worth it. It's just a matter of getting there, you know? Okay, look, take it easy, Google Maps. We can do this. Between you and me, we've had a good game. 30 fucking minutes long, but it's been a good game. Christ almighty, this is a nuts game. It's fine. Look, just do this. Wait for your cooldowns to come back up, and then get ready to do your shit. Google Maps is now dead. Shitballs. Look, the Swiggins got the kill there, and we lost our Swiggins at the same time. Or something. Hold on. No, hold on. Just back off my shit. Thank you. Just die. Thank you. Okay, this is tense. I don't know where to start with this game, but all I know is that it's bad. Like, everything that's happening right now, I'm not pleased with. I'd rather that it would stop happening, whatever it is. Okay. We got enough money for the second rank of Circuits of Time if we didn't already. We do. We're maxed. We have everything we could possibly need. So we got our teleport beacon set up. They still have that, like, last rank of turret. I don't think we can win this, but we can get close. We can at least put up a fight, right? So... okay, I'm gonna drop that there, so hopefully someone took some damage. Not enough damage to get a kill on our side of things, unfortunately, but... okay, they've got the advantage. We need to really nail this next fight if we want to survive it. So we got our teleport beacon set up. Do we use our black hole in advance? You know what? I think we do. It's not... The point of the black hole here isn't even the damage anymore. It's to do enough that... Shit on a stick, Google Maps! Damn it! I really wished that that was not the way that this had ended. GG, well played. Like, if we had stuck together and been defensive, that would have worked out fine, I think. I was ready, I was set up to be defensive, and it just... That was not what happened. It was still a really good game. Like, don't get me wrong, this was a fantastic game, well played by everybody on both sides. I'm just a little disappointed that for us it didn't work out so well, just because we couldn't get the kills, and... Yeah, I mean, the Ted leaving is what fucked us the hardest, I think. Like, Ted was doing fine, more or less, and we probably would have won with that push, but no dice. Thank you, everybody, so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed yourselves. I know I sure did. If you did, be sure to let me know. Hit that like button down below, and I'll see you guys in the next video.